My name is Elias Rios, and this is my last lecture. Chapter 1. An injured lion still wants to roar. If I could choose a simile to represent myself, it would be I am like a grand finale firework. I chose this because grand finale fireworks are very explosive and the best crowd pleasers of all time. As an athlete and a person, that is who I am. I play with high intensity and I am very explosive on and off the field. And as a person, I am one of the best crowd pleasers of all time. I like to make people laugh and just feel good about themselves. And that's what makes me the best crowd pleaser. I'm just saying how I feel, man. I ain't one of the Cosbys, I ain't go to heal, man. I guess the money should have changed them. I guess I should have forget where I came from.
Tell me nothing. Let up the suicide doors. This is my life, homie. You decide yours. I know that Jesus died for. Is the man in the mirror. My biggest excuse, I'll do it after dinner. My biggest dream had me sleeping for a year-er. Procrastination, compromise was my career-er. I had to think this through. What am I gonna do? Will I sacrifice the masses to be the few? Will I re-dream the dreams I once aspired to? Or will I sleep it off and wake up on the avenue? My life,
my life.
Chapter 4, The Parent Lottery. When it comes to the parent lottery, I think I've won it all. I honestly have the best parents in the world. They devote so much of their time, effort, and money into my sports and education, it's not even funny. To show them that I appreciate everything they do for me, I play like my life is on the line every time I step on the field. Also, at school, I give it my all, in every subject. I love you, Mom and Dad.
Like the rapid sun. My life.
Chapter 7. I never made it to the NFL. My biggest critic is probably my father, Elias Rios. Yes, if you didn't know, I am junior. But yeah, he's the biggest critic. Ever since I was little, he pushed me to play the hardest in every sport. Whether it was baseball, soccer, football, he just pushed me to do my hardest. The thing I hated the most, he would sign me up for tournaments I didn't want to play in, or sign me up for teams that I didn't want to play with. But it always worked out, because I always played good with those teams or in those tournaments. And he knows best. Thanks, Dad.
Now I rhyme a brand new song.
I got a new song written in my soul. Speaking new lyrics, listen as I flow. I caught the inspiration, I had a revelation. Not just on one occasion, but now it's all gone. And now it's all begun. Daily reaching up above. Praising till I blow the rung. Praying till I overcome. Playing back this record till my people say it's over. Then I can't even wait for no pretending. No more playing
y'all.
Chapter 11, The Happiest Place on Earth. Sometimes to get to the happiest place on earth, there's going to be a brick wall that you got to get over. And that resembles the adversity and struggles you're going to have to face in life. For me, I've conquered many brick walls. thanks to the support of my friends, family, coaches, and everyone. Chapter 21, Jay. Ever since I was little, my older cousin Moses has been the Jay in my life. He's like an older brother to me. We've done everything together since I was born. And I mean everything. He's also my biggest supporter and fan when it comes to sports. He supports me in everything I do, and that's why he's the Jay in my life. Chapter 28, Dream Big. Sometimes adults are a little bit too strict in life. When I was younger, my parents wouldn't let me sleep at anybody's houses. I was only allowed to stay late and they would have to pick me up. As a kid, this really hurt me because everyone else got to spend a night at their friend's house except for me. So if I could give advice to the adults out there, it would be, let your kids experience everything they can. Chapter 53, Never Give Up. People always have an idea of what they want to become or do in life, but sometimes adversity strikes and they have to do whatever they can to surpass them. There's really two options when it comes to this, give up or fight for what you want. When I was little, I tore ligaments in my elbow and fractured it. This made me want to quit baseball forever, but I just kept fighting and fighting and recovered and finally got back into baseball. Now to this day, I'm playing at a high level, and I'm doing really good. This just shows if you don't give up, you'll succeed. Procrastination, compromise was my career. I had to think this through. What am I gonna do? Will I sacrifice the masses to be the few? Will I re-dream the dreams I once aspired to? Or will I sleep it off and wake up on the avenue? My life. Chapter 56, Make a Decision, Tigger or Eeyore. When I was little, Tigger was my absolute favorite cartoon character in the world. I actually had him come to one of my birthday parties when I was little though. Between the two, I mean when I was younger, I was a big Eeyore kid. During the games, if I made a mistake, I'd really get down on myself. I was a big mental mess and I couldn't get back into the game, but now, I'm older, I'm more mature, and I learned to cope with my emotions, and I don't let them get to me as much, and I'm more energetic, and just like bouncing off the walls. But yeah, between the two, now I'm a Tigger. And that does it for my last lecture project. Thank you for watching. I'm done. Done.